In this video, we'll show you how to bring world-class search to your Supabase apps using Algolia, faster and easier than ever. Developers love Supabase for its simplicity, speed, and flexibility. In this example, we're building an app to answer the age-old question, what should we watch tonight? We've set up a Supabase table with a collection of movies. Each row includes the title, cast, genre, rating, and more. Now let's make this data a little more discoverable using Algolia's flexible, lightning-fast search API. Traditionally, this means building a custom pipeline using the Algolia API client to keep Supabase in sync, but that takes time and maintenance. That's why we built the new Algolia Supabase Connector. It lets you easily sync your Supabase data with Algolia on a regular schedule, no more manual pipelines. Let's walk through how to set this up. Inside Algolia, head to Data Sources in the left-hand nav and select Connectors. Scroll down until you see Supabase and click Connect. From here, we'll fill in a few details to authenticate and start syncing data. First, it's asking for the host. In Supabase, click the Connect button in the header, scroll to Transaction Pooler, expand View Parameters, and copy the host value. Paste that into the field in Algolia. Next, you'll need the Transaction Pool and Session Pool ports. Algolia autofills these using default Supabase values, but you can verify them in the transaction or session pooler settings in Supabase. Now, let's copy the database name. Back in Supabase, copy the database name, it's Postgres in this case, then choose your schema. By default, it's set to public, which is the most common, but if you're using a custom schema, you can find it in the left nav of Supabase. Next, add your username. In Supabase, under the Connect tab, scroll to Transaction Pooler and copy the user. Now grab your database password. Lastly, give your source a name. We'll call this one Supabase Movie Table. At this point, Algolia is pinging Supabase to confirm your credentials. Once verified, you'll have the option to enrich your data with transformations, but we'll skip that for now. Now, let's configure the destination. This is your Algolia index. We'll call this one Supabase Movies Index and let Algolia create the index credentials automatically. Let's confirm that Supabase Movies Index as our destination. Now we'll set up the job and define how often our sync runs. You can run it on demand or on a schedule. Since I want this to update frequently as new movies get added, we'll set it to run every 6 hours. This keeps our Algolia index fresh. You can also choose how data updates. Full re-index, full record updates, or partial updates. We're going to go ahead and choose partial updates so that if, say, a movie's vote count or popularity changes, only that part updates. No need to re-index everything.
Fuck.
Next, we'll select the table you want to sync. Here, it's picking the Let's Watch Movies table. Back in Supabase, you'll see that's exactly the one with our data. You can see all the columns being pulled. The object ID is obtained via the primary key set in Supabase, which looks good. Let's go ahead and create the task and run it. Perfect. After about a minute, we've imported around 8,800 records into our Algolia index. Let's check it out. You can now quickly search your data and we'll search for Jim Carrey. There's Liar Liar, classic. Search Terminator, there it is. Search whatever you want. Now, I don't have to worry about building complex data pipelines or keeping data in sync. Algolia handles the updates from Supabase on a regular cadence, or on demand if needed. I can focus on what matters most, building fast, delightful experiences for my users.